drums, the universal instrument of rhythm, the voice of dance, the voice of festival.
How do the drum communicate to the people? They talk to you, they tell you, they warn you, they praise you, they insult you, they caution you, and they discipline you.
In January 1990, as part of the Commonwealth Games Arts Festival, musicians of over 20 nations gathered in Auckland to talk to each other in the language of drums. This program celebrates that Festival of Drums. Drummers assemble at Otara Marae in South Auckland to be welcomed by the tangata whenua. Sharing breath with the local people, the visiting nations become family. For the next 6 days, musicians from the Pacific, from Europe, the Caribbean, Africa, and Asia will meet, sleep, eat, and share their lives in music together under the one roof.
This is the first time in the cultural field or in the dance field, this is the first time that groups from Vanuatu meet other people who are members of the Commonwealth. And we've never had a chance to meet.
The exchange is what it's all about. It's just stunning. For me, being a Pacific person, it's just bliss, you know. It's just great.
You see, as we are growing, we have to learn. So when we meet each other and then discuss and talk to each other, I think it's a great thing, which I love so much.
These players are all master drummers and teachers and instrument makers in their own right, so and it was a fantastic thrill to meet up with people who are coming from a cultural tradition which is thousands of years old. I mean, it's based on something that's so sort of old and substantial, and yet they're still, you know, creating new music.
The drums assemble for workshops and rehearsal. These first-time travellers come from a village in Malaysia.
Also, that one of the main reasons for us being here, I think, is really to have a lot of fun together, and we want to make this weekend as enjoyable as possible. We do have to produce some concerts, so there's some work to do, but we just feel that it's actually a fantastic opportunity for everyone to really share together and actually have a lot of fun in their music making.
styles of drumming, like the construction of the drums themselves, are as diverse as the cultures from which they spring. The arts of each culture represented at the festival, the landscape and climate, the crafts, the everyday work and dress, the sports and popular skills, all are widely different. But the drummers find they have a lot in common. Almost everywhere, drums celebrate weddings, festivals, harvest time and planting.
Every year we have a competition, and this team is a champion at 1989.
Really?
Yes, that's why I brought it and then part of the prize.
Champion drummers down in the Caribbean. I've traveled all over the world performing on this drum. This drum is called a gumbe drum. It's made out of goat skin or sheepskin and an oil barrel. And this drum carried a background for the rhythm for all our culture in the Bahamas. Our main culture is the junkanoo, which we celebrate during Christmas and New Year's. The gumbe, we celebrate in the summer. It's called a jumping dance, where we use the gumbe drum again for the main instrument. And for all our shows and all our culture, we use gumbe drums. They have the skin here. I know barrels is all over the place. Like, every time I see a barrel, I say, look at drum. So the next beat is a bolero beat. Bolero is 3 and 3.
In traditional Vanuatu, way back about 30, 50 years ago, on hearing that the slit gong on certain islands which had slit gongs, it would convey a message of some sort to them. If there was a tribe coming to attack them, the guard would convey the message to people around in the gardens that there's a fight on or there are people coming to beat us, and it conveys a rifle of a person in a village, he can send out the beat or the tune that signifies his rank. They would know that there's a family member within the rank, they'd know who it is. In special occasions like a death of a chief, they'd signal the tunes over the hills. In this area, the chiefs are not hereditary type chieftainship. The chief is made. Or you make yourself a chief by killing pigs and sharing to the man your clan. And when you get to a certain stage, you have to have an orchestra or number of drums within your Nasara. It's prestige to have that.
In Mauritius, we have our national folklore. The national folklore is called the sega. The sega
usually it's pulsates, it's a dream of the two circular drums you find here. Very long time ago, the Sega was performed only in the coastal parts of the island. And also, Sega was played, you know, during the slavery periods after a hard day's work. So the only moments of distraction, the only moment of relaxation is during the night. So all the people living on the coast gathered together at night and they just put on a fire with wood and they dance till very, very late, even till the morning, dance the sega, which is normally accompanied by alcoholic drinks. This is called the typical sega. We have also modern sega, which is accompanied by, you know, by modern instruments.
Band from Trinidad launched the first public performance of the festival, a free Saturday morning concert for the shoppers at the local Otara market.
Someone will be on later.
Oh well, I've got to go and drop the shopping and then I'll come back and watch it.
Aren't we having a cultural feast here today? Are you enjoying yourselves out there? Where else but Otara can you get such a variety of cultural things happening?
Saturday morning in South Auckland, the National Theatre Company of Papua New Guinea have their own unique way of saying, let's get to know each other. This is a dance of welcome from Manus Island.
Our ladies will take you to your gentlemen, and I will take your girls. Thank you. Yeah.
Drum communicate to the people. They talk to you at the drum. It is a language. So that falls within music. Music is a language. Dance is a language. How is it a language? It communicates to the people. It educates the people on the values, the norms, the history, and the traditions and religion of the people. For those people who could not put their language into written form, you know, there are many ways of recording history. That could be oral tradition. And because they could not write, they used the drum for oral traditions. And the drum will tell you, your father was this. And this man beget this son. And this son beget that one. So it tells you of your family tree. The drum will tell you how brave your father was, how a coward your father was. So you see that the African drum is not just there for nothing, but they are there for a purpose.
Tell them what I say.
You said I was feeling hungry.
Actually, in Africa, all drums talk. All the drums speak. So we don't have a particular drum that we call a talking drum. Even the smallest one says something which there is a meaning. Nobody taught me how to play the drums. From your childhood, you learn. So you grow up. Learning to, it doesn't mean that you go to any person to tell you, play it like this, do it like this. The elderly people don't give us chance to learn the drums with them that way. So the only thing is you get some tins, or sometimes you make your own drum and then go to the bush and play. Because when you are playing it in the house, they say, oh, you are disturbing, you are disturbing. Stop it.
National groups come from traditional cultures for whom drums and dance convey specific and complex meanings. Outside its cultural context, the Ghanaian dance is stripped to a simple rhythm. At this level of sharing, the workshops are a great success. People of Otara Marae cater to a variety of diets and make sure there's plenty of fuel to replace all the energy burnt up in the workshops. Energy which will be focused on creating a public concert in Auckland Town Hall.
We can just make a start, I thought, with getting each group to demonstrate a riff from the material that they customarily play, which they feel the rest of the group here might be able to take up and imitate. For example, I know the Cook Island team have a number of patterns within their playing which can be simplified down that everybody could quite easily do it. And we're looking for patterns that can be used to trigger things at various points throughout the show. So could we hear something first from the cooks, please, if you just perhaps discuss amongst you or just play?
Sharing of rhythm is established. The strands are interwoven. The concert begins to take shape.
Things will have built up. They go down again. There's already a sense of something very sensitive happening. And then through that, the entry of the Bahamas group. Okay, so the Bahamas group come into that. So the whole thing builds up again to a very carnival-y feel. To talk to you just a little bit about the overall structure and the dynamics of the program. One of the things that's really behind the thinking is that we want to have a lot of dynamic contrast, and this has obviously been set right from the beginning with the opening karanga and pōwhiri over the top of the core group percussion, and then the introduction of the Cook Islands group. So we've actually got something very hot and very Pacific feeling right from the start.
Good evening. Tommy Tarima and his students will perform the potpourri for our visitors, participating in this international festival of drums.